All right. Well, welcome to the Imperfect Men's Club podcast. If you press play on the trailer for this show, chances are you're curious about what the Imperfect Men's Club is all about. Well, I'm Mark Aylward.
I'm Jim Gourlay.
This podcast is a space for men to have real, raw, and sometimes difficult conversations to help guide middle-aged men through making hard decisions in life. Both Jim and I are mentors focused on leading consciously. We'll have a new episode for you every week filled with honest and often pretty funny discussions on well-being, personal growth, and professional development.
Here's a sneak peek of what we have in store.
We're both middle-aged guys, high-end middle age, and have led lives, you know, raised kids, created families, created businesses, sold businesses, fell down, got up. I personally went through a very contentious divorce. Guys between, let's say 40, 45 and 65 years old, our age, our generation, we've seen a lot, we've done a lot, but guys just aren't encouraged to open up about some of this stuff. If you fell down, the expectation was you were just going to get up and rub some dirt on it. And as much as that is maybe outdated, wouldn't it be great to find this intersection between masculinity and empathy?
Sharing your feelings or sharing your struggles, depression, anxiety, those things were frowned upon and often laughed at.
There's a lot of middle-aged guys out there struggling with issues that are solvable, they're fixable, and they're just not able to get that help yet, or it hasn't resonated with them yet. And that's kind of what we want to accomplish.
What we've both, I think, learned, because we're learners, from our daughters, a lot about life, and maybe in some ways a better world. When my daughter told me that she was a feminist, it didn't go over so well because I gave her my version of that.
Yeah.
And I said, you're a bra burner. My daughter has educated me on really what a feminist is. And I would say, believe it or not, never thought I'd say this, I'm probably more of a feminist than I realized.
My daughters taught me how to listen better. They taught me certain sensitivities. They've taught me a ton. So what we want to do is bring all this experience, all this life experience and professional experience, successes and failures, deliver the stories with some generosity, some civility, definitely some humor, and hopefully at least one or two pieces of actionable advice that if you're struggling with one of these issues, or you've yet to face one of these issues, that you can walk away from this podcast and do something about that.
That's what I hope to accomplish for our listeners, the podcast, that they get a new perspective and maybe some humility and humor along the way.